Remember to breathe, cause it'll take your breath away when the engines cough and you blast off. Ignite the night with a firecracker flash. Remember to live, cause
hello, I am AxelMC131 and welcome back to the Kerbal Space Program. Happy New Year, everyone, because all my videos that I've recorded have been pretty much before the new year, but I finally got them out, so, some of them. Happy New Year, everyone, and welcome back to KSP, and today I'll be carrying on in the 1.05 career mode. So we're going to go resume save. Here we are. A new start. And going through the editing system for the last video, and I've turned some of the sounds down a little bit, which will make my editing a little bit easier. I have to balance audio so much, so hopefully my voice won't be, you know, counted out, impossible to hear by spacecraft and things. So, when we last left off, we had just sent a rocket with Bob Kerman on board into high altitude science. And at the moment, we don't actually have any contracts, so we're going to go and see if there's anything new over here. Hauling stuff into flight above Kerbin. Altitude. Yeah, no. 5 kilometers to 11 kilometers. Maybe. Test that in flight. Test this at the launch pad. Okay. Yeah, Kerbin and landed, but that technically counts. So, the Rocomax brand decoupler. I cannot remember which one this is. Right. Here we are. Okay, so we're going to grab our little command pod, and which one's the Rocomax brand? I think it's the Command Structural. There we go, that's that one. Just turn it around the other way, and just gonna put that force percent like 10 because this one's pretty powerful. It's just 250 ejection force. Well, I guess it is the same. Okay, and launch this. And once we've done this, I think we're gonna build a new rocket that will be able to escape the atmosphere, which would be a good idea. And hopefully, we'll get some space science. And what I would then like to do is actually unlock the early plane parts, because they are always fun. And we can get science from other locations around the surface of Kerbin much more easily. So, testing this part. Ding! Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Contract complete. Yay. Recover the vessel. That was nice and easy. Okay, let's go and accept the escape the atmosphere contract while we're here. The other reason that I want plane parts, incidentally, is so that I can get on to doing these focused observational surveys. Because they're usually in areas, well, starting off near the KSC, and then they get a bit further off. But they're quite hard to hit with rockets. So, in fact, I can see there are 3 areas here from different companies that they want me to do crew reports in. I think that's the crew report symbol. Some of them in flight, some of them on the surface. But that's difficult without a plane, so that's the other reason that I want them, because they are often worth quite good science, and they're quite fun to do. So, let's go back to the contracts, and get this escape the atmosphere. Yeah. And now we're going to go, and we're going to build a bigger rocket still. So, remind me what we have available to us, because it's a couple of days, it's a few days since the last time I played this, so we do have the Thumper, the big solid rocket booster. We have the Hammer and the Flea, and we have the Rely and the Swivel. Good, good. We have the slightly larger fuel tank. Don't have any control yet. We have the stack decoupler and the radial decoupler and the heat shield, which we will need. Parachute, radiator, radial parachutes, and landing legs, interestingly enough. And both science grants. Right. So let's start up here. So we want our pod, and we want a parachute. We might actually put a couple on this. Because we can get multiple sciencey stuff from here, but I think we'll do that for the moment. And we might put... I'll put two more parachutes on the side here. And we'll put... let's put a heat shield. There we go, because this is going to go into space, so we need a decoupler now. There we go. Now hopefully that should be stable on re-entry. It might be. I don't know. The science unit is not actually that heavy. Let me see where the center of mass is. A bit far up, okay. You can fix that by putting, like, fins up at the top. Like that sort of stuff, but it's a little bit risky, especially because these little ones have a stupidly small heat tolerance. Although, to be fair, we could probably just try and put one. No, I think we'll be able to... I think we'll manage this. I think we'll manage it. We're not coming down from... We're barely going to be going suborbital, so we shouldn't actually have that much behind us, you know? Okay, let's go with these. Let's put a swivel on, because the swivel's more efficient. And also vectors. And we're going to put a decoupler there. And should we go for the big thumper? Yeah, why not? Thumpers actually doesn't give that much more thrust than this in terms of its size, considering it's about 3 times the size of the hammer. But it's got a lot more fuel. How much fuel has it got? 820. Yeah. It's actually slightly more efficient, too. I'm wondering if that's going to be enough. I think I might put another fuel tank. One more should do it. Just drag this up a bit. And put some winglets on. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep us stable. So is the center mass going to be there? Alright. We'll put these little wings on. Just to help us stay stable. Okay. Anything else that we might need? Radiator? I don't think we'll need the radiator yet. I mean, pretty safe with that sort of stuff. Alright, let's check our staging. This is going to be... we'll just label this the Pioneer 3. I think is where we're up to. So, we got the hammer, and then the decoupler, and then the swivel is going to start at the same time. Then we have that, and then I kind of want one of these parachutes to deploy before the others, kind of drogue style. Although, to be brutally honest, with this setup, with that much parachute, what I think I can do is I'm going to put one of these service bays in the middle here. And I'm going to put some mystery goo in the middle. Whoop, not four. Two will do. Whoops, no. Have them aligned. There we go. So we can do mystery goo science. Alright, so let's save this, and who should we send up? Let's send up Val, because Val hasn't gone in a rocket yet. And we also want to have some stability control for this, so check this. I need some monopropellant. Let's just take the monopropellant out of there. Good, good. 24 parts, 14 tons. I think we are ready to go. This should get the to break the atmosphere, so let's have a look. Let's have a go. I possibly should have offset those radial parachutes slightly inwards to to bring them out of the line of fire when we get to re-entry, but there shouldn't be very much. There shouldn't be very much fire, you know. Alright. It's a beautiful day for it. The sun is high in the sky. It's actually afternoon at the moment, probably about 3 o'clock. Alright. You ready, Val? Okay. Gonna throttle up to about 2/3 for that liquid fuel engine. And get ready to go! In 3, 2... Oh, whoops. Well, I hit spacebar a little early. That's fine. Okay. But we're rising quite steadily, which is good. I'm never sure with this thumper. The thumper's kind of a misfit, because you're never sure if you're going to have too much thrust or not enough. I do want to pitch over slightly if I can, so that I don't drop this straight on the launch pad. I probably should have put parachutes on it, actually. Oh well. But we do have a lot of fuel for it, so that's good. So acceleration just going over 2 Gs. We're probably going to break Mach 1 before this burns out. Long drag vector, but that'll get shorter as we get through the atmosphere. And We are going pretty much straight up. I'm impressed by how long we kept that, actually. Probably wouldn't have been safe to have parachutes on anyway, because they just would have exploded. Alright, Val, how are you doing in there? Let's take a look from inside. Yep, looking good. Look out the window. There's the atmosphere before us, and the ocean. Slowly disappearing. Nice. Very nice. We are just about to pass 20 kilometers up, and we still have plenty of fuel in this. We are accelerating nice and slow, which is what I want. We don't need speed here. We go, we're down to about 6 tons of fuel here. Well, not fuel, of mass. And we actually have put up to 3.5 Gs of acceleration if we wanted. Nevertheless, I am not accelerating that fast. Okay, we're above 30 kilometers now. Doing good. Doing very good indeed. Apoaps is almost out of the atmosphere. While I'm still here, I'm just going to open this and I'm going to grab Mystery Goo, because we don't actually have Mystery Goo high altitude signs yet. Yep, there we go. 9 signs for that. Close. And this should be out of the atmosphere. 74, 75, 76. Yep, we are. We'll go up to 80. There we go. And kill the engine. Nice. Okay. Wow, we didn't actually need that third tank. Nevertheless, there is not enough to get us into orbit, of course, but yeah. Right, let's time warp out of the atmosphere from here. Watch the stars appear. And now we're out of the atmosphere. Hey! There we go, we got world first milestone. We've reached space and broken an altitude record of 70 kilometers, which are the same thing in this game. And what's it like up there? We hope it's fun because you're coming back very soon! Yeah, you are actually. Completion rewards, 6 science, very nice. Right, time to be quick. We need a crew report. Thank you. We need to open this up and get the other mystery goo. Observe mystery goo. There we go. And we need to observe the materials bay. 25 science for the materials, 5 for the crew report, 10 for the mystery goo. Awesome. That is like 40 science right there. Let's close that up. How you doing, Val? You are the first Kerbal to escape the atmosphere, at least in this iteration of the space program. Right. We've got pretty much half our fuel. I wonder if we could do a little bit of power descent. Okay, we're going down again. As our altimeter just started descending again. So I'm going to quick save at this point. I've been trying to get out of the habit of quick saving because I got into the habit quick saving every like 10 minutes or something stupid like that. Which was probably a really bad habit. Because you need to kind of deal with things as they happen, so. I like to think I'm getting better at that. Okay, we're coming back down now, so I'm gonna keep this stage on for as long as I can. But let's time warp down again. Now we're out of the atmosphere, of course, we have proper time warp. Until we reach the atmosphere again, at which point it goes back to physics warp. Okay. Let's check out aerodynamic forces. We should be able to hold this position for a bit. I'm just going to watch these drag vectors. It's going to be about 40 kilometers up that we're going to start getting this stuff. So I'm going to start burning now, because we're going to get shock heating soon. And I kind of want to ditch this stage. Wow, we're actually going down behind the KSC, probably because the planet's rotated while we were up there. Okay, we're getting down to 25. Stop, I am getting drag vectors here. This is pretty good, this is quite stable. It's good. Whoa. There was a little bit of wobble there as I said that. In fact, yeah, I can see these drag vectors appearing now. Okay, we're down below 400, I'm going to ditch this stage. I'm going to go sideways, and stage! And hopefully this thing will be stable in this direction. Ooh, well, it's certainly trying. Okay. And we are slowing down, which is good. Wow, we didn't even need the heat shield, really. Oh well, good to have it on for safety's sake. Always good. And our lovely drag vectors here. Ah, must be the parachutes there. Just being on the side there are keeping us stable, because they have their own little drag vectors. Our radial parts. Slightly annoying like that. Right, so when are we going to be safe to deploy? At about 260, I think. If I turn this sideways... Oh! We get lift vectors! Hey, how cool is that? I can actually guide this sideways. Hey, look at the retrograde vector move. Whee! Okay. First parachute out. Turn the SAS off. And second parachute's out. Whoa, okay. There went the orbital... Well, not orbital stage. The insertion stage, I suppose. Okay, parachute's open. And 5 meters per second descent speed. Awesome. That's beautiful. Okay. And we've been... almost just under 7 minutes flight time. Okay, we're 800 meters up. And we're gonna just time warp all the way back down to the ground. Okay, we're getting very close to the ground now. I still don't know why we don't have a shadow. I cannot explain that, unfortunately. It might be my graphic settings. I may have accidentally turned it off. Oh well. But we're about to hit the ground, so just turn SAS back on. And touchdown. Oh, there's our shadow. Okay, it was just all the way over there somewhere. And we have returned. Awesome. Val, you are a wonder. So while we're here, we're actually going to EVA Val. We're going to go and grab our crew report. Take the data and store it again. We're also going to do an EVA report, so this should be flying above the grasslands. Yay! Because we're that far away from the KSC now, and we can do another crew report from the grasslands and get that little bit of extra science. Fantastic. Recover. Okay, 104 science. 64.1 science earned from that. Lovely. Absolutely delicious. Okay, next. Just under 5,000 funds from recovered parts, and 1 XP gain for Val. Alright. And that is another milestone. Broken a speed record of 790 meters per second. Nice. Let's go to R&D, and we can get some new experiments. So the aviation stuff I definitely want, because the plane parts are just so much fun. Alright, research, 45 science. And we've got the new little Juno Mach 0 engine and the small intake, which I love. And the beautiful new Mark 1 cockpit. Ah, yes, right. So what else do we want? We've got general construction, which includes the structural fuselage and the crew cabin. We've also got, the Terrier liquid fuel engine, which would be good for orbital maneuvers if we want to go to orbit next. Flight control, some better fins, and a reaction wheel. So that's what I was talking about in terms of external gyroscopes, is basically what that is. And we also get basic science here. This also gives us bigger radiator panels. And batteries. And the Stay Putnik. Stay Putnik, if you actually get the joke within that, because one part of that joke is a parody of Sputnik, and the other one is the fact that it keeps crew safe by making them stay put. It took me a long time to realise that second one. I was quite ashamed when I realised it. But we also get the battery and the thermometer and the bigger comms dish. This might be more effective, actually. I think this is probably a good idea to get, so I'm going to go with the basic science. And we can actually probably send an unmanned probe into orbit first. Although I think that the contract doesn't allow it. The contracts actually force it to be a manned vehicle. So, do we have any other contracts now? Anything else to test? We can haul the Juno into flight between 2,000 meters and 4,000 meters. Okay. At a speed of 70 to 130. Well, that's easy. Yeah, let's do that. Let's build a plane that will take this engine into the sky. Ferry 3 tourists safe to destination. Tourist contracts are always nice, but we don't have a appropriate crew cabin for them yet. I mean, we have the one Mark 1 command pod, but it only seats one, and we'd have to attach one of those annoying drone command pods. The probe cores, that's what I was trying to say. So I think for the moment we'll stick with this. Try and take things one step at a time. So, let's build a plane.
Where was I when the rockets came to life and carried you away into the alligator sky? Even though I'll never know what's up ahead, I'm never letting go. I'm never letting go. Remember to breathe, cause it'll take your breath away when the engines cough and you blast off. Ignite the night with a firecracker flash. Remember to live, cause you're gonna be free.
remember to dream, cause it's gonna be a starry night over every town as you look.
Alright. And there we go. I think this will work quite nicely for what we have in mind, which is a very light plane, capable of, well, reaching the desired altitude of between 2 and 4 kilometers, and the desired speed between, what is it, 70 meters per second and 130? Yeah. So we'll just disable those, and we need to come up with a name for this. So I will just run through what we have here. So we've got the little service bay in here, which has 2 mystery goo units, 2 thermometers, and 2 batteries, so that we have power to transmit through this antenna at the back. And then we have a science unit here, 2 Juno engines on the side there, and our wings here. And I will actually just assign these control surfaces properly. So that's pitch, this is going to be roll, that's going to be pitch, and this is going to be yaw. So we should have good pitch authority here, for one thing. And I will actually toggle torque so that the reaction wheels are disabled in that, because I don't think we'll need them. This thing should be nippy enough. Although I might move this front wheel forwards a bit, because it's got a very short wheelbase at the moment. Okay, so we've got to name this now, and we're going to name this the, that small little thing, canard. Call this the Sparrow one. There we go. This is our, the start of our space program. Well, this is the start of our aviation, space program. And this is what Phoenix is good for, of course. The aerospace part. The aero, putting the aero in aerospace. Alright, let's go. And here we are on the runway. The very, very bumpy, horrible runway. So, oh goodness! Okay, that was interesting. Now, let's just check our control surface. We'll turn our brakes on. Bring that up. Track control surfaces. That's our yaw, that's our pitch, and that's our roll. Good. And we've got Jebediah on board. Howdy do. Let's, while we're here, we'll actually get, we might get some science from the runway. Should we? Or should we get some while flying? I guess we've already got, I don't know if we've got materials while flying. I can't remember. Well, first of all we have to do is get this Juno into the air. So I think we'll do that first. That should be our primary goal. So, let us start the engines. Okay, spool up a bit, take the brakes off, and go. Oh, this is bumpy. Come on, pull up. No idea what this takeoff speed is going to be. 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. And off the ground. Okay, so just above 40 meters per second, she'll get into the air. Nice! Good job, little Sparrow. Right. So now we need to get climb a little bit, get between 2 kilometers and 4 kilometers, so just going to break 2 kilometers. And keep a speed just over 70 meters per second, there we go. And while we're here, let's get observed materials bay. While flying Kerbin, yeah, we didn't have this, that's 17 science there. Nice. Let's open this and get some more science. Let's get, I think we've got the mystery goo flying at Kerbin. Yes, we do, but there's still a little bit of science to be gained, and we can log our temperature. Yeah, 5.6 signs. Temperature scan while flying over the shores. And if we're lucky, we might get it while flying over the water, too. I can't remember exactly where the water starts and where the shores stop and it officially becomes ocean. Let's try it. Nope, that's still the shores. We can get signs from the ground later on, I think. That's the water. There we go, 5.6 signs. Okay, and do we get a crew? Have we got a crew report while flying over the water? No, we haven't. All right, let's get that. Okay, we're at 1 kilometer up. Let's actually, the crew report we can transmit for full science value. Let's let that thing extend and transmit that data. There we go, 4 science for that, straight up. And we've got plenty of power, which is being recharged by the alternators on these engines. All right. Keeping, maintaining speed quite well, which is good. Very nominal flight so far. ...1600 meters. Plenty of fuel for what we need to do. 1700. 1800. I assume that it just pings once you've got all of that. Yeah. 1900. Come on. And 2 kilometers. Yep, that's it. That's all you have to do. Awesome. I've never actually completed one of those contracts before. The haul complete. 2 signs for that, and 21,000 funds. Lovely. Alright, time to return to Kerbin, Jeb. Well, return to Kerbin. Return to the KSC. Hello, abandoned runway. We'll go visit you another day. Yep. Right. Let's pull around here. Whoa, this thing has a lot of your authority. Which is... Whoa. Problem with having things with lots of control authority is that they become quite difficult to control carefully. Like, if you're not pulling crazy maneuvers, they don't fly hugely well. Let's throttle back up again, because some of them start falling out of the sky. Alright, I think we'll land next to the KSC rather than on the runway. Because that runway is... It's bad enough taking off from it, but landing on it is even harder. It's quite a neat little plane, actually. It's always fun creating planes from the very first tier, because you don't actually have any, with the exception of the science junior and the service bay, and the Mark 1 liquid fuel tank and the other rocket fuel tanks. You don't really have a lot of 1.25 meter parts, but the engine and the fuel tank and the air intake that go with it are 0.625 meter parts, or Mark 0 parts, so it's kind of hard to match them up, so I'll just do things like this. Did a similar thing in the last career game I had. Well, the one that I tested some of the parts in, but this was probably the last thing that I made in that game. Oh, we're coming down pretty fast, actually. I'm going to kill the engines here, because we're going down far faster than we need. Pitch down some more. Nice and stable. Let's get some yaw action in here just to slow us down. This is the thing that real planes actually do, which is yawing from left to right like this. Ooh, ground's coming up a mite fast, which will slow you down a bit. Also, flaring like this and then going down again. Our speed dropping off there. Awesome. We might swing around actually and try and land alongside the runway on the north side of it. Hello, KSC! It's so nice to see you! Crew report while flying over Kerbin's shores. Well, we already have that. Wow, this is beautiful. Because we don't have an R&D bridge to fly under yet, so we'll just pull around here. Let's, realized a little late that my speed had dropped right off there. Oh, well, now we're on the ground. So I guess that works. Let's brake. Brake, 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 brake. Force that nose into the ground. Get below about 15 meters per second and we should be safe to turn without rolling the thing. There we go. Just roll our way back over to the runway. Because we actually get 100% return funds for parking this thing on the runway, I'm pretty sure. Actually, while we're here, we can probably do a little bit more science. We get crew report from the KSC. This is our space center here. We're home. Yes, transmit that. Because then I can do another one without having to get Jeb out and then back in again. Although, having said that, the thermometer readings we might be able to get, so I will actually stop here. Open this up. And I'll have Jeb pop out. I can't remember if Jeb can... Can you reach from there? You can't. Okay, never mind. Well, Jeb can't actually reach, so we'll just close that and we'll carry on to the runway. Accelerate again and... Oops, turn the brakes off. Doodle-doo. Just going for a little ride in my Sparrow. It's actually very controllable, this plane, even on the ground. So it comes with putting those little early game wheels, which are actually quite cute. Okay, up onto the runway. Yep, okay. Not quite making it. Let's get some thrust in there. Go on. Up the hill. Up the hill you go. There we go. And a crew report from the runway, which we will keep. And recover the vessel. Awesome. So that's another contract completed, and a whole lot more science gained, if I'm not mistaken. We're up to 53. 32 science earned for that. Lovely. So I'm wondering what our next objective is going to be at the R&D center. Do we want... We've got this flight control stuff, which gives us the reaction wheel there. But I'm wondering if we want to go for either general construction because of this, and also the strut, and the structural fuselage, and the stability enhancer, or these, mainly because of the Terrier engine. Don't know. I think we might want to be going into orbit before we do any crew missions. So I think what we'll do is we'll research this. Get the next steps, and then we have the science. We'll get the science that we require for these next bits and so forth. But I think we'll call that there for this episode. So we have achieved space, I suppose you can say. We've achieved space and we have achieved plane. So yeah, space and plane. Not the two of them together, unfortunately. That'll be a while coming before we get space planes. But we have achieved space and we have achieved plane and we have achieved science. So yeah, I think I'll call it there. Until next time, where we'll be pushing for putting something into orbit, I reckon. Until then, guys, I've been XLMC131. This has been the Kerbal Space Program. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Where was I when the rockets came to life and carried